Our next guest of honor is Adnan Sohel, advisor SSDC, and he's from Dubai. He's a learning and career consultant.
Thank you so much, Soft Skills Development Center. It's my indeed a pleasure. What soft skills are, what skills can a human possess that robots or technology cannot? Why I'm asking this question? Because we have almost reached in the era, which is the era of artificial intelligence, robotics, and we are talking about machine learning, data science, data analytics, deep learning, Python, robotics. So these things, if you talk about 10 years ago, 15 years ago, these used to sound like these are just some mysteries or some fancy words, but now we are living in a digital world. Answer of my question, I would give myself the answer, and that's the human skills, people skills, behavioral skills, which is associated to a person's behavior, how we interact with other human being. That's why I have some reservation when people say it's a soft skill. I say better to call it as a human skill. Soft skills give it a feeling like it's a less important, like when we talk about any soft element, soft gesture, soft impression, it means that this thing is not that much important. But clearly, we all know soft skills has a hard impact on people, on societies, and on to the organization. There was a study done by Deloitte, which reported that soft skills intensive occupations will account for 2/3 of all jobs by 2030. That's not so far away. Just 9 years, we are going to reach to 2030. And hiring employees with more soft skills, it can increase a company's revenue by $90,000. The age of automation is no longer a future prediction. Now it's a reality. World Economic Forum estimates that approximately 1.4 million people will lose their jobs due to automation and other technological changes by the year 2026. As more and more job activities become automated, soft skills, which cannot yet be replicated by machines, have become and will be in future more important. So what are those soft skills? The list is long, but just to name few: communication skills, emotional intelligence, creativity, self-motivation, empathy, integrity and ethics, adaptability, resilience, and the list goes on. Just to name few I mentioned here. Because these matters, as the companies these days coping up with digitization, with automation, and with the constant change, whether it's the change because of the COVID-19 or it was already in their plans, multinational companies, banks, blue chip companies, they are continuously going through a constant change. So creating a culture where people can communicate ideas, it is crucial now. So people can collaborate, they can share their thoughts, and we can understand when people speak and others are listening to them. It matters. People feel value and people stay longer in those organizations. For employers and workers, it's crucial now, more than ever before, I would say, to focus on refining humanity defining traits. The traits, the skills which make us human. So we need to take steps, organizations, hiring managers, as a society, we need to step forward. Such skills remind us that what it means to be a human. And there are people who hear us, what we say, and they truly care. Even in this tech-driven society, over 500,000 graduates from universities, roughly these are the figures, a country like Bangladesh, country like Pakistan, almost 1 million, country like India, almost 2 million. Every year, graduates come out from universities and they look for jobs. Do you think all these people get jobs? Not really. As everyone has same title, MBA, BBA, MCom, same sort of degree from similar university, from similar rank of the university. So what can differentiate to these students? That's the answer is soft skills. If everyone in during the interview is talking about same thing, that I'm having these skills, I have this knowledge, I have this understanding of the technical area of this. So how recruiter will differentiate? It is said hard skills will get you to the interview. Like you have good hard skills on your CV, you sent the CV, they took you for interview. But your soft skills will get you to the job. So anyone from students, if our younger graduates, soon to be graduate are listening this session, they should consider that they have to understand the importance of soft skills. We have all seen the situation, especially living in UAE, talking with HR managers, learning and development managers, working in recruitment industry and training and development industry. I have personally seen it, and I'm pretty much sure we all have gone through or observed such situation with decisions to hire when two candidates almost are having similar level of hard skills is made based on the soft skills. Because companies see that who is going to be a right fit for this job, apart from those technical skills where everyone is on same level, who is going to fit for that organization culture? Who is going to be more resilient in the time of crisis? Who would be having more self-leadership? Who would be better at communication, to communicate with people? So differentiator is a soft skills. These skills are incredibly important when it comes to work with human. I know, we all know that we are in a digital era, and sooner robotics and data and artificial intelligence, it will be all around us. Around 50% jobs which we have today will not exist in 2025. And the jobs which will be in 2030, 80% still does not exist in this world. So we clearly can see that what can take you forward are the soft skills. That's the time we need to invest in our human capital. There are many online tools which can help people and their organizations. And as this event is happening, and SSDC is doing amazing work in the region, in the country. So there are a lot of tools online, offline, and a variety of training courses also exist. You can get just in a couple of dollars, from $10, $7, $6, you can buy courses on different platforms to enhance these human skills. It's otherwise, simply I would say, if you cannot go and you don't want to buy, just go. Google is free of cost. Just work on that and you will find a lot of resources to develop, enhance your skills. Universities, colleges, professional organizations, and even parents must step forward to recognize the importance and impart behavioral skills. This is so unfortunate that people love to send their kids to expensive schools to get technical knowledge. But the basic skills which should be taught to these kids from the beginning, during the college, at the time of university, societies are lacking in that. In West, they have understood and realized this thing, and they started to work so hard in the organization and on the society level to develop these skills, and same what you are doing. So there, as a human, something is this, that what we can do and robots will never be able to do that. At least I cannot see in coming or foreseeable future that robots will be taking care of these soft skills. They will not be creative. They can work on things. They are not creative. They don't have empathy. They cannot communicate with people and understand the feelings of others. They don't have emotional intelligence. They are just working on programming. So it's a good news. As a human being, still we can have these skills and we can grow in our coming future. And that's for sure. We can learn these skills. Thank you so much for inviting me. And I wish everyone watching this session and SSDC all the best.
Thank you so much, Adnan Sohail bhai, for your wonderful speech. If possible, please be with us in this program.
It's my pleasure.